MIT researchers have developed a solar-powered desalination system that is more efficient and less expensive than previous methods. An estimated 2/3 of humanity is affected by shortages of water, and many such areas in the developing world also face a lack of dependable electricity. Widespread research efforts have thus focused on ways to desalinate seawater or brackish water using just solar heat. Many such efforts have run into problems with fouling of equipment caused by salt buildup, however, which often adds complexity and expense. Now, a team of researchers at MIT and in China has come up with a solution to the problem of salt accumulation, and in the process developed a desalination system that is both more efficient and less expensive than previous solar desalination methods. The process could also be used to treat contaminated wastewater or to generate steam for sterilizing medical instruments, all without requiring any power source other than sunlight itself. The findings are described in the journal Nature Communications. Many attempts at solar desalination systems rely on some kind of wick to draw the saline water through the device. But these wicks are vulnerable to salt accumulation and relatively difficult to clean. The team focused on developing a wick-free system instead. The result is a layered system with dark material at the top to absorb the sun's heat, then a thin layer of water above a perforated layer of material sitting atop a deep reservoir of the salty water, such as a tank or a pond. After careful calculations and experiments, the researchers determined the optimal size for the holes drilled through the perforated material, which in their tests was made of polyurethane. At 2.5 millimeters across, these holes can be easily made using commonly available water jets. The holes are large enough to allow for a natural convective circulation between the warmer upper layer of water and the colder reservoir below. That circulation naturally draws the salt from the thin layer above down into the much larger body of water below, where it becomes well diluted and no longer a problem. The researcher says that the advantages of this system are both the high performance and the reliable operation, especially under extreme conditions where we can actually work with near saturation saline water, and that means it is also very useful for wastewater treatment. The researcher adds that much work on such solar-powered desalination has focused on novel materials. But in their case, they used really low-cost, almost household materials. The key was analyzing and understanding the convective flow that drives this entirely passive system. This new approach provides a promising and efficient path for desalination of high-salinity solutions and could be a game-changer in solar water desalination. Just as hot air rises and cold air falls, natural convection drives the desalination process in this device. In the confined water layer near the top, the evaporation happens at the very top interface. Because of the salt, the density of water at the very top interface is higher and the bottom water has lower density. So, this is an original driving force for this natural convection because the high density at the top drives the salty liquid to go down. The water evaporated from the top of the system can then be collected on a condensing surface, providing pure fresh water. The rejection of salt to the water below could also cause heat to be lost in the process, so preventing that required careful engineering, including making the perforated layer out of highly insulating material to keep the heat concentrated above. The solar heating at the top is accomplished through a simple layer of black paint. So far, the team has proven the concept using small benchtop devices. So the next step will be starting to scale up to devices that could have practical applications. Based on their calculations, a system with just 1 square meter of collecting area should be sufficient to provide a family's daily needs for drinking water. The necessary materials for a 1 square meter device would cost only about $4. Their test apparatus operated for a week with no signs of any salt accumulation, and the device is remarkably stable.